course a great shock to the parents and to the students. Is there a realistic possibility of saving the school? And related to that, is there a strong need to save it?
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, to think of it, this is one of its kind school in the UK. And I, for one, get my kids all the way from about an hour away just so that they could, you know, get to know the Indian culture, the Indian values. And academically, this is one of the top schools in the country. It's been consistently ranked in the top 5-10 league, in the league tables. And with regards to the turnaround, there are a number of parents who are senior corporate professionals who specialize in different areas of finance, accounting, marketing, etc. And together, we've come up and put together a corporate turnaround plan. If the Board of Trustees and the Board of Governors are willing to take into account some of the considerations, then I'm sure that we can, you know, work towards continuing the school beyond, you know, the next 2 years.
What are these plans? Can you outline them, even if you don't detail them for us? What broadly are you planning to do that would sustain the school that they couldn't do?
So we took a look at the numbers, we took a look at the financials, we took a look at the student numbers, the attrition rates, etc. And what we realized is, given certain assumptions, which, you know, we have to take in place when we build these plans, given the reserves that are in the trust, the school can run at least for the next 5 years quite easily, assuming absolutely no new students coming in. However, if there are, you know, nominal increases, etc., then the school can continue to run for the foreseeable future. Again, this needs to be vetted by the trustees and the governors, and, you know, together I think we can make this happen.
Now, what is the experience for children? It will be quite traumatic for children to be yanked out of a place where they are in a structure, be scattered, lose their friends, lose their teachers. It's quite traumatic for the children to do this so suddenly.
Absolutely. It's not just traumatic for the children, you know, that, you know, that they're not, you know, going to see their friends from the next term of in the next couple of years, but it's also quite traumatic for the parents, because as parents, all we have been doing in the last 1 week is calling up different schools in the vicinity just to find out their places. And unfortunately, you know, some of the parents are having to, you know, put their kids into some schools which is not even in, not which were not even there in their list of preferences when this whole thing started. We can never find any other school like the Swaminarayan School in terms of everything: academics, culture, the values that they imbibe in children. Absolutely, you know, nothing comes close together. And in the last year or so, you know, the kids, my kids have been here only for about a year. My kids have had several play dates with their classmates. We got to know the parents really well, and this whole movement has, you know, brought the whole school together, and we're working, you know, as one big family. And all these contacts, all these people who have come together, you know, are fighting for just one purpose: keeping the school open for as long as possible.
See, the reason that the trustees would have taken this decision is because it became unsustainable. So, is your plan intended to work with them, together with them, in tandem and in support, to see that you can deliver a workable result? And in that, would you just give them ideas or assurances as well?
Absolutely, absolutely. The idea is to work with the trustees on various, you know, parts of running the trust. And this includes support from some of the parents in capacities of corporate finance, accounting, marketing, the operational side of it, the regulatory side of it, compliance, legal, running campaigns with print, TV, media, etc. Whatever it takes to keep the school running for as long as possible. And the idea is to work with the trustees, with the Board of Governors, with the school. So this is not a fight, you know, against someone. This is a fight, this is a movement, you know, for us, so that we can do this together.
And they would perhaps welcome the new support that they're getting through the parents by way of all sorts of input. Does that include some access to financial support that you're planning to
possibly
raise?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, we can go, you know, beyond what we're doing here right now. We can look at, you know, crowdfunding. We can look at, you know, raising funds for the school. for the refurbishment, for you know the sustenance, for pretty much everything where there's a shortfall. And I'd just like to cite a small anecdote. So just like, you know, the mandir was built by volunteers, brick by brick, I'm sure, you know, and we see the results, I'm sure something can be done about the school as well in this phase where the parents come together, volunteer the time, effort, money, and we put it back in place.
Thanks.